What's going on, guys? I'm here in the amazing Brazil. I'm in Búzios. As you can see with the view behind me, it's absolutely spectacular. I could certainly get used to this. If you're anything like me and you love traveling, you might be considering a destination wedding, and I figure there's no better place or opportunity for me to make a video about that subject, specifically about whether it makes more sense for you to fly out a photographer or hire somebody that's a local there on the spot. So one of the things I really want you to consider with regard to that is the ability or the opportunity to meet them beforehand. And I mean of having a sit-down physical meeting. This is a wedding, first of all, is already a big responsibility and a very important day in your lives, especially a destination wedding, because there's, you know, more moving parts, there's more things that could potentially go wrong, and you just want to make sure that everything is planned out and organized as effectively as possible. So having a sit-down meeting with your photographer before the wedding, or much earlier before the wedding rather, is really, really important in my opinion. Getting to know them on a more personal level, making sure that, you know, you like them, you guys vibe well together, making sure that they're experienced on a, you know, on a technical level and really knowledgeable from that perspective. Having the ability to sit down and kind of discuss their style and just to, you know, get to know them on a more personal level, I think is really important. And that's not something that hiring somebody over there overseas will give you the opportunity to do. Doing an engagement session is also really important, and I made a whole separate video on this subject. It's titled Five Reasons That You Really Need to Do an Engagement Session. So definitely give that one a watch, and it'll kind of go more in depth into that subject as far as getting to know your photographer, building trust with them, because they're really one of the only vendors that spend pretty much the entire wedding day with you. And on a destination wedding, you know, that's really, really, really important, and I can't stress that enough. While the destination wedding photographers that are there local on the spot, that they're, you know, the recommended vendors by the venues that you guys are looking at, and I'll get into that subject, by the way, in just a second. They're recommended for a reason. Those guys, they will know the area, they will know the venue inside and out. They might have shopped there 50 or 100 weddings or anything like that, but in my experience, whenever I shoot at a new venue or a new place, new city, you know, as I'm exploring, I feel like I have this completely like creative overload, overwhelming amount of ideas that come to me as far as new fresh perspectives that I'm bringing, that maybe they even unconsciously, although they've shot there so many times before, they have more of a cookie cutter approach. And I feel like you deserve so much better than that. You know, it's more about just having the same exact photo as the last couple that they shot last week. From that perspective, I think it's actually really beneficial to bring in somebody with a fresh set of eyes that will give you that unique experience and make your wedding something completely different than what they will be able to provide to you, because they've been shooting there for so long. And like I said, they are recommended for a reason. From my research, I don't know if that's exactly, I can't speak for every venue, for every photographer out there in the whole world, but from my research, these venues take anywhere from a 30 to 50% cut of whatever the photographer is charging you. Interpret that how you may, but I certainly wouldn't be happy if somebody was taking 50% out of my wallet. And whether or not, you know, that affects the way that they communicate with you, the way that they are interacting with you on the wedding day, and how they're treating that wedding from a business perspective is unknown to me, right? Everyone's so different, but just keep that in mind as you're doing your research. Now, many venues, they will actually charge you a little bit of a premium to bring in somebody of your own choice, and that might be a non-venue recommended photographer that is local to the area, or somebody that you are flying in from your country or your state. One of the loopholes kind of around that, this doesn't always work, but one of the loopholes around that you can consider looking into is having your photographer stay at the same venue where you're staying, the same resort, for example, a minimum of, I believe, 2 or 3 nights, and then they're counted as just another guest. And from that perspective, the venue sees them as just a guest, not a photographer, and they're able to waive that fee. So I can't speak for all the venues, like I said, but look into that, because it's a very common loophole from the research that I've done myself. One of the other issues that you might find that, you know, you run into with hiring somebody that's local there to the spot is communication issues because of time zone differences. So you might not have answers to your questions, to your emails in a timely fashion like you might with somebody local to you, as well as, of course, a language barrier. If you're flying somewhere, if you're going to get married somewhere where you know the local language, that might not be an issue for you. But that's something to consider if you aren't familiar with the area. If you don't speak Spanish, if you don't speak Greek, I did a destination wedding in Santorini in Greece not too long ago. The groom was Greek and he spoke Greek, so that was great. You know, we were able to, even as we're walking through the area, through the city of Ia, he was able to ask for permission to go here, take the pictures there. That's not something, you know, that you're going to be able to do if you don't speak the local language. So yeah, while those, you know, those might be a little bit smaller issues that we can work around, such as the language barrier or you know, how fast you get a response to your email because of time zone differences, I think those are like more smaller issues, although they might add up. One of the big things I want you to consider that could potentially get pretty serious, and knock on wood, this has never happened to me or anybody I personally know, but I do see a lot of articles and, you know, it pops up in the news occasionally where wedding photographers disappear with your photos, or they demand a whole, you know, bunch more money because of some little loophole in the contract or something like that, that they set up that you might have overlooked. And I want you to avoid those situations. Now, the contract is set up to protect both parties equally, and having to enforce the contract after the wedding in the municipality, you know, where, or wherever the venue was, wherever you're hiring that local photographer out there, imagine having to fly out to that country again just to go to court, you know, just to get your images back, or just to argue, you know, that you don't need to pay more money to get your images, things like that. It certainly wouldn't be fun. And having flying somebody out and having that contract signed in your local city or state, wherever you're from, really gives you an extra level of protection, because if anything does go wrong, you're able to fight that in court locally to you without having to, you know, without the hassle of having to fly out again and completely ruin your memory of that country that became so special to you where you got married. So I definitely want you to avoid those types of problems. Do your due diligence. Make sure you look at reviews. Make sure you look at, you know, just research a lot about all of the vendors involved in your wedding day. And that goes not just for destination weddings, obviously. It goes for your local ones, but I think even more so for destination weddings, because you have a little bit of less control. It's less easy. It's not as easy to, you know, communicate with some people. There's a lot more obstacles involved sometimes versus flying out your photographer that you know locally. You know, maybe it's somebody that was recommended to you by word of mouth, somebody that shot your one of your friends' weddings or things like that. So much of my business comes from word of mouth referrals, and I cannot appreciate it enough. It's really the best compliment that anyone can ever pay me, is to just, you know, spread the word about what I do and how much they enjoyed their experience working with me and the photos and things like that. So I really can't thank you guys enough for all the word of mouth referrals, because so much of my business relies on that. So, you know, having that word of mouth referral really gives you that peace of mind that you're going to be working with somebody that is known, is trusted. They've already proven themselves once before to somebody that you know and trust. So that kind of goes, you know, without saying. So this is a really quick video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you a little bit of an insight. Like I said, do your due diligence, research. Of course, budget appropriately. I know one of the biggest concerns with flying somebody out is budget. But it doesn't have to be expensive, you know. If you find somebody that's really passionate about travel, there are certainly ways to cut down costs. For example, for me personally, for any weddings booked in 2019 and 2020, for select destinations only, with one of my higher packages, which start at $4,000 US, I'm waiving travel fees up to $1,000. So it's really a steal for a destination wedding. You know, I love traveling. I love that I'm able to merge my two passions of photography and travel together, see the world, explore the world, meet new people, photograph weddings and couples, you know, all around. I photographed, like I said, a wedding in Santorini in Greece. That was my first like big destination wedding. I've done destination weddings in locally, like domestically in the US as well. One of my first weddings ever was in Chicago. And recently I also did an engagement session now in Iceland. Yesterday here in Brazil, in Arraial do Cabo, I did a honeymoon session, which came out absolutely amazing. You can check all of those out as a featured story highlight on my Instagram at jredziniak. So I hope you guys enjoy those. I'm slowly building my destination portfolio, which is why I'm able to offer you know, this really big amount of credit towards travel and waiving the whole travel fee. So I hope you guys take advantage of that if you are looking to fly out your own destination wedding photographer to wherever you're choosing to get married. So yeah, like I said, I hope this video helped, and I'm gonna head to the beach right now. So ciao.